Africa Rice. Rice science at the service of Africa. Rice has long been a popular food for some countries in Africa, such as Egypt, where rice yield is one of the highest in the world, Senegal, where the national dish is a delicious combination of rice and fish called chubu, and Madagascar, which has one of the highest per capita consumption of rice in the world. Rice consumption in Africa is growing faster than that of any other major staple. It is West Africa's single most important source of dietary energy, and the third most important for sub-Saharan Africa. Although production has steadily increased, it has not been able to keep up with the continent's rapidly growing appetite for rice. Between 2008 and 2016, milled rice production in sub-Saharan Africa rose from 10.9 million tons to 15.5 million tons. At the same time, rice consumption jumped from 18 million tons to 27 million tons. Rice accounts for 12% of all agricultural imports in sub-Saharan Africa. The continent is spending about $7.5 billion for rice imports, according to FAO. However, there is evidence that if supportive measures are taken, this trend can change. Sub-Saharan Africa experienced some dramatic changes in the rice sector just after the food crisis. Paddy production growth rate shot up from 3.2% per year before the food crisis, to 8.4% between 2007 and 2012. Average rice yield in the region jumped by about 30%. This surge in rice production and yield was a result of key investments made by farmers, governments, the private sector and the donor community to boost Africa's rice sector. The yield jump was encouraging evidence of increased use of knowledge and innovation generated through research in Africa, particularly by AfricaRice and its partners. AfricaRice is a leading Pan-African rice research organization, committed to improving livelihoods in Africa through strong science and effective partnerships. It is the only CGIAR research center with African ownership. Its contributions include improved seed and cropping practices, technical information, capacity development, policy advice, and support to the development of rice markets and value chains.
For agricultural successes, it all starts with a seed. AfricaRice Gene Bank holds the largest rice collection in Africa, with more than 20,000 rice seed samples, including over 2,000 samples of Oryza globerima. The indigenous African rice is a rich reservoir of genes that confer resistance to stresses endemic to Africa. The center conserves, uses, and shares with partners the rich diversity of the African rice gene pools. AfricaRice and its partners have used the genetic resources to develop more than 200 improved rice varieties over the last 25 years in Africa. The most recognized output has been the development of the new rice for Africa, Nerica, a family of varieties, which is grown on more than 1.4 million hectares in Africa. An impact study conducted in 2015 shows that Nerica has contributed to lifting about 8 million people out of poverty in 16 African countries. High-yielding rice varieties for irrigated areas, called Sahel, cover more than 85% of the Senegal River Valley. The present value of net benefits from the Sahel varieties is $24.6 million. A new generation of high-performing rice varieties was launched in 2013, under the name Advanced Rice for Africa, or Arica in short. 18 Arica varieties have been nominated by 2016. Africa, which still relies on rain-fed agriculture, is becoming increasingly vulnerable to climate change. The center has adopted a new breeding strategy to accelerate the development of rice varieties adapted to the changing climate. AfricaRice and its partners study the problems caused by rice diseases, insect pests, and weeds in the main rice ecosystems. They have developed a basket of rice crop management options for rice farmers, so that farmers can get the most value out of inputs and save land, water, and other natural resources, in addition to increasing yields. One such technology is a crop management decision support tool, called Rice Advice, which allows rice farmers in Africa to apply mineral fertilizer more efficiently to optimize production and profits. AfricaRice studies have shown that the adoption of Rice Advice recommendations, can increase rice yield by 0.6 to 1.8 tons per hectare in farmers' fields.
AfricaRice and its partners have developed the Smart Valleys approach for land and water development in inland valleys. Using this approach, farmers in Benin and Togo are able to raise rice yields under rainfed conditions from 2 tons to 4.5 tons per hectare. Weeds are a major constraint to rice production. An interactive tool helps identify nearly 200 different weed species of lowland rice in East and West Africa, and provides practical information on how to manage them. AfricaRice is promoting small-scale, locally adapted machinery targeting land preparation, weeding, harvesting and processing. The Aussie thresher, for example, is one of the important improved post-harvest technologies for rice in sub-Saharan Africa. The center and its partners are finding ways to add economic, nutritional, and environmental value to rice by reducing post-harvest losses, improving grain quality of new rice varieties, and exploring eco-friendly uses of husks and straw. AfricaRice has developed an energy-efficient parboiling technology called GEM that combines a uniform steam parboiler and an improved parboiling stove. The GEM technology is helping to significantly improve rice quality and reduce the burden on women processors. As an intergovernmental association, AfricaRice plays a key role in advising scientists and policymakers in member states on critical rice production and marketing issues. AfricaRice economists have provided technical support to help African countries develop and implement national rice strategies under the framework of the Coalition for African Rice Development Initiative. AfricaRice economists conduct studies to have a better understanding of the problems faced by actors of the rice value chain and help set research priorities. They also study the impact of technologies on farmers' livelihoods.
In sub-Saharan Africa, rice is primarily a women's crop in the rain-fed upland and lowland ecologies. AfricaRice addresses gender gaps in access to technologies, knowledge, specific technology needs of women. It seeks to modernize rice farming in Africa, lessen the burden on women, and turn it into a viable agribusiness, attractive to young people. The center is helping develop the next generation of rice researchers and technicians in Africa, and strengthening the capacity of rice value chain actors, mainly through its new AfricaRice Training Center in Senegal. It has developed farmer learning videos, manuals, and training modules to share rice technologies and knowledge with farmers to help improve rice production. AfricaRice scientists are based at the center's headquarters in Côte d'Ivoire, and its outreach stations in Madagascar, Nigeria, Senegal, and in Liberia. In close association with its national partners, AfricaRice operates through a continent-wide task force mechanism. A network of rice hubs has been set up, where research products and local innovations are integrated across the rice value chain, to achieve development outcomes and impact. Within the hubs, farmers are linked to marketing channels and markets, through business-focused innovation platforms. The center is helping to mobilize global rice knowledge for the benefit of Africa, through the CGIAR research program on rice agri-food system, called RICE, as part of the Global Rice Science Partnership. RICE is led globally by IRI and in Africa by AfricaRice. As part of this partnership, the center works closely with IRI, CIIT, JERCAS, CIRAT and IRD and many universities and partners from the public and private sectors. AfricaRice's role as a champion in partnership building has won recognition, both in Africa and on the international scene. AfricaRice is contributing to the global and continental agenda, including the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals and the Comprehensive African Agriculture Development Program, as translated by the Malabo Declaration. On behalf of the millions of African rice farmers and consumers, who are benefiting from the use of AfricaRice products and services, the center thanks its financial, scientific and development partners for their strong support.